Ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce Dr. Chandramouli Pathak ji. He's a very good friend of mine and perhaps my first guru on entrepreneurship education. He's an international expert in entrepreneurship development and an internationally certified Start Your Business Trainer by ILO. I will not spend more time. I promised him that by 11:45, I'll hand over the session to you. Dr. Chandramouli Pathak, please take over. I'll stop my sharing.
Hello.
Yeah, we can hear you, sir. Go ahead.
How are you all? Can you hear? Am I audible? Okay.
Sir, we can hear you. Don't worry. We can hear you.
So it is so nice to connect with all of you from India and from other countries also. Now, this is the beauty of the corona or pandemic, you can say. In the difficult time, I think we are all lucky to get connected. Otherwise, this would not have been possible. And thanks to Pradeep ji, Rotarians, and all our young team who have made it possible. And I also like to thank my co-panelists, Mamta ji and Nitin ji, for strengthening my views on it. I have a few things to share. Pradeep ji has already mentioned something about entrepreneurship and enterprise and opportunity. So like I always say, my job is to really convert all of you into entrepreneurs. It is something like when a businessman gets a client, he is very happy. So today I'm very happy because I'm getting 200, 300 clients who are all potential entrepreneurs or maybe existing entrepreneurs. And my job, my responsibility, my output depends on how they get converted into entrepreneur, successful entrepreneur, growth-oriented entrepreneur. That is where the contribution of the motivator, trainer, educator comes. It is not just an education of giving lectures. This is the difficult time for all of us, we know. All of us are facing the uncertainty, have a lot of anxiety, have a lot of fear, fighting with the risk, and we are all waiting to come out of the problem, right? I think all of you are feeling the same thing, and many of us are very hopeful. Many of us are thinking that when will it happen? This is exactly the mindset of an entrepreneur when he or she wants to start. She is anxious, uncertain, and I always say from my 40 years of experience that those of who are anxious, excited, worried about fear, they are the right people to become entrepreneur. Because what is entrepreneurship? It is nothing but facing the risk, uncertainty, anxiety, success, and coming out of your own problem for the betterment. So this is the basis of entrepreneurship. And I see that more difficult time, the entrepreneurship will flourish more. Because the real entrepreneur enjoy working in difficulty, enjoy solving problems, enjoy exploring opportunity. Those who wait may be waiting, but those who are entrepreneur will grab this opportunity. So there are plenty of opportunities today. And we will see. I don't want to go into the process of opportunities, but I'll tell you what opportunities are existing today. And you can select one of it, or you can identify how to diversify, how to expand, how to modify your products. So I think what I would like to say is, first of all, what really triggers entrepreneurship? Who pushes to become entrepreneur? Why you would like to become an entrepreneur? Who tells you to become an entrepreneur? Is it educator? Is it motivator? Is it your father? Is it your mother? Can be. Yes, I don't deny it. But the ultimate inner desire comes from you. And I know many of you have desire. You want to become an entrepreneur, but you are not able to take a step forward and just waiting. And this is where I want to help you. Now, let us go to the next step. So I'll start my presentation. I'll be using some slide, but I don't want you to get tied out with the slide. So I will share all the experiences. Can we share slide? Okay. So the topic was given to me, but I have a little bit retitled it. And I have named this Entrepreneurial Economy and Opportunities. Because nowadays, whatever is going to happen is an entrepreneurial thing. Because in the new economy, maybe a down economy, maybe upcoming economy, maybe a growth economy, there are plenty of opportunities. And entrepreneurs can really take advantage of these opportunities. One of the ways to make people become an entrepreneur is to attract them, to lure them with the basket full of opportunities. If I show you some opportunity and which is convincing to you, I'm sure you will try going ahead. I always give an example of a small kid, small child going to a toy shop, khilone ki dukan, toy shop. When he goes to the toy shop, he sees so many toys. He picks up one, hold it for some time, then put it back and say, no, I want this one. Again, he puts it back, then say, I want this one. Now, this is exactly the situation we should create for our youth, that we can offer them basket full of opportunities from which they have to select. As child is not able to decide which one to take, we'll also have to guide entrepreneur how to select which is good for you, how to select which is viable, how to select which is market-oriented. And I'll tell you some tips about this also. So what is going to happen is, there is a new economy coming up, as I mentioned. Sharvil? New economy which is coming up. Sharvil? Which is helping you to really take up. I think my slides are stuck up. So what I would like to say is that new entrepreneurial economy is offering you a different scenario. Next slide for the yes. Thank you. Okay. So see now what is the scenario now? There's a rapid evolution of knowledge and technology. I think the world is full of global and social media and technology and everything. And this is going to be a change now, whether you want to say it post-corona, pandemic, post-pandemic, a new life, new thing. And I would like to say people are talking about new normal. I was saying that nothing is normal for entrepreneur and everything is new for entrepreneur. So entrepreneurs should not feel that we are in normal situation, and they always to look for new things. And this is what is going to happen to the world, not only to India, to the world. Germany, USA, we are participants. They are at a different level of technology. India, Nepal, they are at a different level of technology. And I'd like to give you a few examples of technology, how it's going to dictate the world of entrepreneurship. The first example that comes to your mind. Is of the, what is the latest technology which we are all used to? Mobile, isn't it? I think the mobile has made us, our life, I would say, very enjoyable, very useful, and sometimes very miserable also. Youngsters especially, I know that they will put their mobile near their bed, immediately in the morning, they will take the mobile. So this is a wonderful product. Look at it from the technology viewpoint, from the product viewpoint. What it has done is, they've made us slaves of this product. Ye hum inke gulam ho gaye hain. Toh aapki product kaisi honi chahiye? What kind of product you should offer so that your client become habituated and he wants more and more of your product. He becomes slave of your product. This is one indicator of the new technology. Second thing, by the time you have bought new iPhone or new telephone something, the next model comes into it. So you regret, oh, my mobile is old. So the new technology is coming. So how the technology is helping entrepreneurship? Technology is helping entrepreneurship in terms of offering new features, new services, and most important part from the entrepreneur at a lower cost. iPhone pehle milta tha, usse sasta milta hai. So this is what you have to look for when you are doing an opportunity. That offer something better, better services, and try to see you can offer at a competitive price or not. Knowledge, plenty of knowledge. I think it is overloaded. So don't get dragged away by knowledge, but try to find out what is the critical knowledge for you to make decision to become entrepreneur. Only use this knowledge. Second thing, because of new technology, because of knowledge, everywhere the new lifestyle. After all, why we want to become entrepreneur? After all, why we want to earn a lot of money? Because we want to enjoy a new lifestyle. So the whole new lifestyle is emerging now. I remember I went to Thailand and Maldives and other places, and I saw one of the spa. I think most of the most wonderful spa and pretty luxurious. Even if I talk of hair cutting saloon today, when I went for, I have not gone for head cut since long, but when I go there, there are people, youngsters sitting there and doing all kind of facial and shampoo and other things, and they throw 1,000 rupees, 500 rupees at a stretch. So what is happening today? The lifestyle has changed. People want to have better life, better aspiration, and don't mind. Even rural people are spending money for hair cutting, for hairstyle, for marriages. So I think the old myth that there was a time where people will go for lower product, now they want a better value product. They don't mind paying more. So don't think you have to always produce something which is cheap. On the contrary, now there's a feeling going on. If your higher prices are there, it is a better quality. And if you keep lower prices, people will think it is not a good quality. So think the psychology which is changing here. Second thing, I think the aspiration is changing. People want now safety, security, luxury, status, especially youngster. So when you're deciding a product, don't think of the product, but think how it is going to appeal, how it is going to help your client. Second thing, global influence and new communication. Now it is a global world. You cannot say that I'm going to manufacture something in Pune, but the global influence is going to help you. C.K. Prahlad always used to say that he met someone on one of the Brazil beach sitting with a laptop. And he asked him, young boy, what are you doing? He said, I'm doing business with the whole world, multi-million dollars sitting on the beaches. So now no office required, no big efforts required. You can do business on your computer. So this is the global influence. Communication, you can reach anywhere through media, through social media, through communication. So this is the advantage the entrepreneur can take. Third thing, the change in demographic profile. The new class and need is emerging. I think I can see the all young people here. And I was reading in the newspaper, the news came in India that more than 35 to 40% of the population is below 25 years. And this generation is called Generation Z. And what are their expectations? Highly experienced, motivated, innovative, loyal, want to make a change, want to have a good life, want to earn money. Now, this is your client. Don't treat them as youth, but this is a big clientage. And think as a youth, what you will need. What is it? You want something exclusive? You want something personal? You want something very specially designed for you? Like in fashion design, I was talking to Niv, and they say, we would like to design a sari or a shirt with nobody, like Sabba Sati. They design one sari, 5 lakh. So exclusive market. Nirma has decided the other way around. Nirma says, sab log badi badi baate karte hai, toh I will go for rural market. So there are top market, there are below market. So when you decide product, think of the class, the target market, whom you want to address and understand the need. Now this thing is also allowing you to connect with customer today. I was reading an article and they say, connect with customer. And there was very one good point. They say, now there is going to be a technology clash. Technology is not independent of human being, their behavior, their emotions. Emotional, artificial intelligence is there, but people and human being have emotion. Now, I think in marketing, the emotions, I edited one of the New York program, digital emotions are going to become very important. You make a decision of buying something. Let me give you one example. Now, if my wife goes to buy some good dress, she's not a decision maker. My granddaughter will influence her what kind of dress. So when you decide about the product, decide who are the influencer who will help your client decide whether they should buy it or not. It can be father, mother, mentor. So I think it's the whole dynamics of market they have to understand in the new context. You will say that, Saab, you are all talking about big, big thing, but what about money? We don't have money. Now access to finance is also now available. I wouldn't say very easy. But venture capitalists, if you have an idea, people are ready to invest. And it is called pitching the idea. If you pitch the idea in 5 minutes, and if they are convinced about it, they are ready to invest. There are some good people like angel funding, crowdfunding. One of our friend in Gujarat created a film, social film through crowdfunding and generating about 35 lakhs of rupees. So if your intentions are good, if your products are good, if it's market oriented, people are ready to give. Now government schemes are there, microfinances are there. So this is very fertile. And I think quickly, I would like to justify my point. Economy, see all organization, education, health organization becoming entrepreneurial. They understand their client, which is the best school. They offer best facility to the client. And one of the most important thing for our India, and that too maybe for Nigeria and other African countries, untapped rural market. C.K. Pallad always used to say the rural market and the bottom of the pyramid is the big, big market. Why don't all of our youth think about it? He has given an example that why ice cream is only costing $5 and $10. Why it is not costing only 5 cents or 1 rupees or 5 rupees? If this is the price, see the big market. So I think bottom of the pyramid, the rural people, the rural market. And one example of big rural market is a lot of foreign agencies and foreign institutions are interested in investing in India because the rural market is very big. So I told all my entrepreneurs, friends in India, that if people coming from out of the country are going to face the market, what are you doing? Why are you waiting? Just venture. So the new generation, new post-corona, new thing, new aspirations are coming, new avenues are opening. Socially concerned. Now social concern is going to be very, very important. Is it environmental friendly? Is it ethical important or not? It is renewable or not? So while you select the project, do consider this. Global concerns of gender, disparity, discrimination, these are going to decide. Like in one of the handloom corporation carpet weaving, when the child labor were there, the other countries rejected. How can you employ child labor? So these are the factors going to be very big. So it is an entrepreneur. Even government will have to be entrepreneur. So entrepreneurship is living a few years and then waiting to get it done. I'll skip this. The four stages of becoming an entrepreneur, first of all, you have to conceive an idea. Many people think of becoming an entrepreneur, but if they don't have idea, then you prepare your business plan, then you implement, you manage, you succeed, and then again, you have to succeed in a certain time. Now, what are the opportunities? Let me share a few time, 5 minutes on opportunities. Education field, see this is in education, entertainment, environment, agriculture, energy, health sector. Health is not only physical health, mental health, spiritual health, so many types, lifestyle, fashion, IT services, mobile applications, social services, franchising, takeover business, media, TV, music, industry-based. You can think of plastic, you can think of auto parts, you can think of import substitution, defense, ISRO. So many things are sea wealth. Below sea, there is wealth, space-based opportunity, defense, security, hospitality, wealth. I'll give you one example. Let us say education. Now, what you can do is take a sector in the center and draw a line. What can you sell? Can you sell education equipment? Can you sell education furniture? What you can make? Can you make education application? Can you make some notebooks? What are the other outcome you can say? What kind of services outsourcing you can do? Now, sitting at home, you can do tuition. One of my students is doing tuition sitting at home and earning $2, $5 per hour for foreigner teaching them mathematics and English and science. So it is possible. Now, what you have to do is take one sector in the center and draw a tree-like decision. Let everything. What I advise to my entrepreneur, don't select one product. Initially, generate an idea. And then we will narrow down. I'll tell you how to narrow down. The service sector is one of the emerging sectors, and India has grown because of IT service and other service sector. Hospitality industry now is in difficulty, but a lot of hotel tourism are coming up with personalized tour, private tour, car having special facility, leisure weekend tour, convention training center, health services, especially for child care, senior citizen, business concern. Business entrepreneurship is not only manufacturing, it is consultancy, providing services to rural people for agriculture, for education, for training, washing, car, clothes, housekeeping in garment industry. Big scope exists for washing cloth, ironing cloth. Home delivery now, online marketing, everybody knows everything to be delivered home. Big market. Logistic is going to be a big, big opportunity. Security and safety are going to become. And now you see every home and security service, investigation services, fashion styling, you become advisor, food catering services, arrange party. In one of my college, I promoted one of the entrepreneurs to arrange birthday party on the college. They have 3,000 students. So every month he gets a business. Fashion styling, food catering, professional languages, report writing, research services. Now, I think yesterday we attended one of the very good sessions of management. He says, company will hire part-time expert from outside. So you can be an outsourcing agent for the others, depending on your expertise, public relations, network agency. So there is a plenty of opportunities. But what happens to you now? You are confused, right? So let me tell you very simply. these three things are very important. The entrepreneur, that means you. The enterprise, that means type of the opportunity, business, small, micro, manufacturing, servicing, technical you want to involve, and the environment in which you are going to operate. Now take only, which is the starting point? Would you like to start with entrepreneur? Would you like to start with enterprise? Would you like to start with environment? It is difficult to say. You can start with anyone, but ultimately you have to combine all three. And the one question that I would like to ask you and give me quick response is, what leads to success and growth? Who is more responsible for success and growth? Is it entrepreneur? Is it enterprise? Or it is environment? Tell me something. What do you think? What leads you to success? Entrepreneur, enterprise, or environment? Yes, I just tell or write on whatever you want to say. He has raised the hand, so can we hear him, Akshay? Hello? I'm not able to hear him. Okay, anyway, we have a limited time. So Akshay, sorry, I'm not able to reach to you. But I would say that not only one factor is important. It is the combination between the entrepreneur and enterprise. Environment is constant, whether you are in India, Germany, where you have to study the environment. And this is where the opportunity selection comes for environmental scanning. The entrepreneurs start environmental scanning to find out what enterprise, what opportunity is good. And like it is a matching the entrepreneur capability with the enterprise. So let us talk about the two things. The entrepreneur is made up of what? Inke paas kya hai, wo kiska bana hua hai? Basically a motivated person. And from our study, it says that achievement motivation, he is not after money. He wants to achieve something on his own and prove to the world that I can do something better and I can succeed. This is called achievement motivation. Need to achieve, need to excel, need to do better. And the people who have this motivation have certain manifestation of competency. And I'll talk, there are 13 competency which we have studied. Because I think all of you are suggesting so many names. So there was a study made and we have zeroed down on 13 competency. So I will say, let us say initiative. He is not waiting for anyone. He's just initiative and taking the risk. Second is persistence. Wo jo bhi kaam leta hai, wo chhodta nahi hai. Kitni bhi dikkat ho gayi, whether he's a failure, but he's persistent. And third thing is information seeking. He always seeks information, goes to the entrepreneur, goes to the market, goes to the competitor, goes to and try to find out the real information. And one more quality, influencing strategy. Ab main iska example dunga, aapke ghar mein koi chota bachcha hoga, aapne dekha hoga, he has all these qualities. Initiative bhi hai, risk bhi hai, persistence bhi hai. Information to itne pooch raha hai, he goes on asking to father and mother, and then ultimately mother will say, okay, stop man, I will just slap you. And as soon as the mother raises her hand, the kids hugs mother and start kissing the mother. This is the influencing strategy. Now you see, when all of you are child, whether it is in Africa, Asia, Nepal, India, any country, all of us have this latent potential entrepreneurial competency inside us. But this is not developed because socialization, education system, family, peer group, friends, they suppress your capacity. So now you have to do some activity so that these capacities are sharpened. And this is what is an entrepreneurship education. You have to sharpen this capacity, which is already hidden. We do it by giving project, we do it by giving assignment. And this is how you sharpen and become more entrepreneur. So what motivates you? I think there are four or five things will help you to become either your own motivation. If your motivation is little weak, we offer you market pull opportunity. If that is also little weak, the educator, trainer, motivator will also help you. And then ultimately all of us, including you and we, have to help you identify the right product. But let me tell you, people will advise you, but it is you who will have to decide what is good for you. So now I think the theories have changed. It said it is not only good market opportunity, but what you can digest, what are your capabilities, what are your limitations. Understand then, you may think of becoming Mark Zuckerberg, but initially you have to succeed with your own capacity, own skills and own abilities. So start from who am I, why I want to do it and do it. So opportunity seeking, I will conclude in 2-3 minutes, is something like you have to wear a new spectacles. So you have two eyes. One eye for sensing and seeing the opportunity. A lot of people tell me, I will do this. How can you do it? Seek information, scan the environment, and persist of doing it. But the second eye is the action and vision. If you go on only searching opportunity and don't have vision and action, it is no use. You have to grab that opportunity. Don't wait for 2 years, 3 years. Grab the opportunity. So both eyes should work simultaneously. And I was saying that opportunity without action is like a butterfly. You go on flying, looking for opportunity, and you will never become an entrepreneur. And you just see the opportunity and plunge into it blindly. So it is a wrong entry, and you will blame somebody. Oh, this is not a good opportunity. So try to use the both eyes and try to do it. Few risks I would like to caution. Try to always assess 4 risks: technological risk, product failure. Technological risks, I don't have to explain, because many technology will become obsolete. Many big technology companies are also going to be in out of business. So think of future. Think of new technology. Even if you are not into technology business, technology is going to influence your business. So don't discard technology. Product failure means these are all products which will be out of market. So if their entry, when the product is failure, it's called life cycle. So entry, what is the right time for the entry? Market failure because of competition, lack of effort, not understanding the market, offering something market don't need. Financial risk, you start with low money and go on borrowing money, so burden ho jata hai, cash nahi rehta hai aapke haath mein, because you spend money, so no cash most of the people have, and you don't have control of finance. I think most of the entrepreneurs fall in love with that product, and you know what happens when you fall in love with someone. You become blind and don't you see anything. Now entrepreneur has to be very clear. See outside, see nearby, what is happening, what are the changes, what are the risks you are containing. And the last part, your managerial risk, planning, monitoring. I think entrepreneurship is not only doing, entrepreneurship is not operating, it is achieving and checking at each moment, where have you reached and what is the next destination. So monitor, make a plan B, and then also delegate. Don't do alone, have a team. You alone will not be able to face so many people. So make a wonderful team. In startup now, team is giving a lot of importance. So think of the team also. So the last slide, I would like to say that, what is success ultimately? How do you define success? There are different success. Big success, multi-billionaire, unicorn, average success, middle success, average success. All entrepreneurs are success. So don't worry. Once you start from the ladder small, and if you lay your foundation very strong, you will go up the ladder and become big. But if the foundation and initial part is not set, and how do you reach your success? Success is liking yourself, liking what you do, and liking how you do. You should decide, take the advice, but you decide the gut feeling, third eye, and be committed and honest to yourself. Yesterday only, I think Narayan Murthy lecture was there, and he said, if you are honest in offering something consistently, don't worry about your difficulty or failure, but offer best services. Nowadays, the market don't need only product. They need value and something product plus. And something more than product you offer, you'll be always successful. And this is a mental activity. Don't get confused. You don't have to do market survey initially. Just think of product and do snapshot, quick market survey. Once one product or idea clicks your mind, then start your journey. Till that time, the mental activity, ask people positive, negative, and then derive at a situation. So if you have ideas, and then your own motivation will go up, nobody will have to follow up, and you will go on asking people, and you will enjoy traveling on your journey and reaching to your destination. So I wish you all the best, and I'm sure this will help you to think widely and motivate you, and I'll be very happy to help you wherever you want to help. But ultimately, you have to decide. Many times entrepreneurs ask me, tell me something, but ask me, what do you want? So when you go to expert or mentor, be very specific what you want. And all mentor helper will not help you in all aspects. So also find out who is that expert and what you want to ask. So thank you very much, and I wish everyone, and congratulations to Roti and Pradeep ji and team for organizing such a wonderful seminar and giving me an opportunity. And I'll be very happy to work with youth, teachers, trainers, whosoever want to become, anybody can. And people ask me, what is the right time? This is the right time to become entrepreneur. There is no good time, bad time. Thank you. All the best. Pradeep ji, thank you.
Good. Arey Patel sir, just pull down your screen, please. Sharing. I am so impressed. You are the real Maharshi and Guru. I knew you will talk well, but I did not know you will talk so well. It's so beautiful. In fact, if I see the chat box, people are saying there's somebody from Nepal who's saying hello, everyone. Greetings from Nepal. Rotaractor Sushma. Respected Chandramouli sir is very motivated, motivational at the same time. It's very interesting. Oh my God! Thank you, thank you.
Thank you Sunit very much. Says, प्रदीप जी ये सब जितनी कंट्री आपकी है सब कंट्री में मैंने काम किया है नेपाल के साथ के साथ सीरिया लियोन के साथ दिस आर ऑल वेरी पोटेंशियल कंट्रीज अनफॉर्चुनेटली राइट एजुकेशन एंड मेंटरिंग इज नॉट अवेलेबल
यस 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 सो वी आर गोइंग टू वर्क ऑन इट टुगेदर दैट इज व्हाई यू विल सी दैट वी आर ट्राइंग टू वर्क एज अ ग्रुप इन साउथ एशिया ट्राइंग टू सी दैट वी हैव अ कॉमन डेस्टिनेशन See when jaise kehte na if you live together and are happy with a good neighborly relations then you can progress very well as a family you will have a happy life so let's hope
I'm very happy out. That they are happy yeah. I'm very happy that they are very happy
yes yes somebody is saying inspiring somebody is saying very fantastic informative part thank you sir thank you
thank you
mujhe abhi shabd nahi hai aapko dhanyawad dene ke liye but thank I'll continue
you.
Now
my pleasure
thank you very much I think I have to now come is my video on Okay, good. Huh? Kiran Lal ji, are you there, please?